Hello, my name is John Payne, and I'm a technical marketing engineer for Cisco Secure Firewall. So let's get into the multi-instance capability for Secure Firewall 3100. Traditionally, this is a Firepower 4100 and 9300 capability using the on-box chassis manager for provisioning multi-instance. Policy enforcement, of course, is handled by FMC, while hardware events are viewed in FCM, like interface status change, hardware bypass status, etc. Now, multi-instance on Secure Firewall 3100 series is provided through a single management solution via FMC. And here, just a quick couple terms to go over for this demo. Native mode is what we call an FTD application that either cannot support multiple instances or in topologies where multiple instances are not needed. In essence, we utilize the full capabilities of the hardware to run the FTD application. Multi-instance mode is what we are calling the FTD application running inside a container with the ability of multiple instances of the application running simultaneously. And here we can see the various allotments to each device model when it comes to instance support. In this release, there is no support for the 3105. However, the additional models in the product family add support for multiple instances. The configuration workflow requires first running CLI commands to enable FMC as the MI manager, then registering the 3100 as a chassis device in FMC. Before this step, the firewall is running in native mode. It will need to be converted to container mode, but more on this later as we walk through the demo. Once registered, we can update the physical interfaces, create container FTD instances, and assign or create various interface configurations. Then, we can deploy container configuration, and any subsequent updates can be made to each container instance. And then real quick on high availability, the option on the left here, each instance is acting as its own separate context with its various resource constraints. Or, the alternative is having an HA pair. The caveat with this is that the primary and the secondary units of the HA pair cannot be on the same physical chassis. So you'll see on the right that active instance A and standby instance A are on separate physical chassis, but more on what this looks like from the FMC later on. All right, so jumping into FMC, this environment has an FMCV currently managing one secure firewall 3120, one on version 7.3, and there is an additional 3120 on 7.4 that we will provision. And lastly, there is an FTDV on version 7.1. What you'll notice here is that an FMCV on version 7.4 can manage your devices running various software releases if applicable to your environment. I've opened the CLI session to the standalone 3100 in native mode. We'll plan to add this as a chassis to the FMC, but first must be converted to container mode. We'll now need to navigate the scope system where we can set the deploy mode on the chassis to container mode with the set deploy mode container command. Confirm the change and the system will auto reboot. Note, when the chassis reboots, it will be a fresh install of the device and all prior configuration will be lost and the chassis will be set to container mode or multi-instance mode. These terms are interchangeable. Go through the day zero login steps on the box by setting a password and assigning an out-of-band management IP. New in the software release is the create device manager command that we will use in order to configure the chassis to be managed by FMC. Enter the details of the FMC on the CLI, specify a registration key, and hit enter. Confirm your configuration with the show detail command. So jumping back to FMC, I'll create a group to organize the container instances in the device management page. However, this is not a required step. Click Add Chassis and we'll enter the details of the 3120 that was converted to container mode previously. The progress can be tracked in the message center, and now we will move to creating the container instance. Click the Manage link in the chassis column of the Device Management page, which will bring you to the Summary tab, where you can view and monitor the chassis at a glance. In this pane, you will see most of the configuration that was previously in FCM on the 4100 and 9300 devices, now built directly into FMC for Secure Firewall 3100. Now on the Instance tab, click Add an Instance and in the pop-up window, read and accept the EULA. Click Next, and on the Instance Configuration pane is where we can configure the container instance settings. Fill in the device name, IP information, SSH password, and firewall mode. In the Resource Profile dropdown, you can choose from three predefined profiles or click the plus icon to create your own. Each profile allocates cores with their respective counts noted in the dropdown. For this example, we'll use the small profile. When choosing a resource profile, ensure that you do not overallocate the chassis as oversubscription is not supported. Here, we will allocate interfaces to the container instance by selecting the plus icon next to each interface. Next, you can choose an optional device group, and for this demo, I've created a group specifically for the container instance previously. Choose an access control policy and an optional platform settings policy, along with smart licenses you would like to apply to the device. On the remaining page, you can view a summary of the configuration parameters and click Save to exit the configuration pop-up, and then save inside the Chassis Manager window to begin deployment and auto-registration of the container instance. Deploy changes and you can track the progress in the Message Center. Once the changes are pushed to the managed device, the container instance will automatically deploy and register to the FMC. So now I wanted to jump to the supported device configuration when it comes to making container instances highly available. I have done some work in the background and have not only upgraded the remainder 3120, but deployed two container instances per physical chassis. FTD01 and FTD03 are running on 3120.01, and FTD02 and FTD04 are running on 3120.02. So we are landed at the device management page of the FMC, and we can select Add High Availability, and we'll enter the configuration parameters for the HA pair. Give it a name, select your device type, and then your primary and secondary peers. Here we'll enter the HA link configuration and click Add. The HA pair is added to the FMC under the device management page, but use the message center to track the progress of the deployment. If needed, we can add additional interfaces to the container instance since we use one interface for the HA link. On the device management page, click Manage on the 3100 chassis, which will bring you to the summary page. Here click the Instances tab, then edit the respective instance where the interfaces need to be added. Click Next to go to the Interface Assignment page, and then allocate the required interfaces. Then click Next and Save to exit the pop-up, and then we'll click Save again in the Chassis Manager page. You will need to deploy in order for these changes to take effect. This concludes the demo for 3100 multi-instance. Thank you, and catch you in the next video.